Hello friends, in today's video we will discuss a definition of theodolite, types of theodolite, some of the applications and component parts of theodolite. So let us start with this small definition of theodolite. A theodolite is a simplest form of surveying instrument in which we can measure horizontal as well as vertical angles. Now there are two types of theodolite. One is transit and other is non-transit. A theodolite is said to be a transit theodolite only if the telescope is rotated along the vertical plane through 180 degree. If the telescope is not rotated along 180 degree with vertical plane, then the theodolite is said to be a non-transit theodolite. Now let us move to some of the applications of theodolite. See, with the help of the theodolite, we can easily locate any points on the ground. As well as if we want to find the gradient of a ground, we can find the slope of the ground with the help of the theodolite. First one.
Thula.
No, pele. Now let us know some of the applications of the theodolite. Number one, if you want to locate the points on the ground, we can easily locate it with the help of the theodolite. Number two, if we want to find the gradient of the ground, then also we can find it with the help of the theodolite. Number three, if we want to know the difference in elevation between any two points on the ground, then we can easily measure with the help of the theodolite. And finally, if we want to set a curve along the highway, it will be set out with the help of the theodolite. So all these are some of the applications of the theodolite. Now let us move to the component parts of the theodolite. Let us know the components from the bottom of the theodolite. See, at the bottom end of the theodolite, you can see a plate. This plate is said to be a foot plate, and just above the foot plate, three screws has been attached. So these three screws are known as foot screws, or else it is also said as leveling screw. Why we are naming this screw as leveling screw? Because with the help of these three screws, we will level the instrument. Now, just above the screws, another plate has been attached, and this plate is said to be a leveling head. Above this, you can see a horizontal circle, horizontal plate. This is said to be a horizontal circle, and in this horizontal circle, two plates has been attached. The bottom plate is said to be a lower plate, and the top plate is said to be the upper plate. Within the horizontal circle, there are two scales which is mounted within the circle. The bottom scale is said to be the main scale. The upper one is said to be the vernier scale. In the bottom scale, we can measure the horizontal angle from 0 to 360 degree. In the vernier scale, we can only measure the readings are only in the terms of 0 to 20 degree. If we want to measure the horizontal angle, we can measure it with the help of the lens which is provided here. Now, within this horizontal circle, there are two clamps. One is the upper clamp, other is the lower clamp. See, this is the lower clamp. And this one is the upper clamp. The adjacent clamp which is attached to the upper clamp is said to be the upper tangential screw, and the adjacent one which is attached to the lower clamp is said to be the lower tangent screw. Now you can see a level tube here which is attached to the horizontal circle. So this level tube is said to be the plate level. The help of this plate level is whenever you want to find the horizontal angle, or whenever you have to take any levels with the help of the theodolite, we have to make sure that the bubble is at center. So for bringing the bubble to the center, we have to use these three foot screws. With the help of these three foot screws, we can level the instrument. Now, along with this horizontal circle, a frame has been mounted. This frame is named as A frame. This is named as A frame just because it is in the shape of A, or it is in the form of the letter A. Again, now with this A frame, a circle is attached. This circle is said to be the vertical circle. Again, there are two scales is mounted within the circles. Those two scales are said to be the main scale and another is the vernier scale. Again, in this main scale, we can read the reading from 0 to 90 degree. And again, in the vernier scale, we can read the reading from 0 to 20 degree. Now, if you want to find or if you want to take the vertical readings, then we can easily read the reading with the help of these two lenses. Here you can see the another bubble tube which is attached to the vertical scale. This is said to be a latitude level. Now, you have to level this bubble tube with the help of these foot screws whenever you measure the vertical angles. Now, see, for this vertical circle, a horizontal component of the theodolite is attached. That horizontal component is said to be a telescope. Now, this telescope has two parts. One is, at one end of the telescope, an eyepiece has been attached. And at the other end, an object glass is attached. Now, to bring the telescope in the horizontal direction, you can make use of this clamp. This is said to be the adjustable clamp. Now, the last component of the theodolite is this one. This screw is said to be the focusing screw. Whenever if we want to focus any object, with the help of this screw, you can focus it. See, in today's video, we had discussed about the definition of theodolite, types of theodolite, and some of the applications as well as component parts of theodolite. Thank you.